climate change is a fact in Africa now, and the situation will get worse if radical measures are not taken to drastically decrease the emissions. We need a profound transformation in all aspects of society in order to contain the wider impact of climate change. In many parts of Africa, for the people who has 40 years old and above, they really don't need science and then to understand that climate has changed, because they have seen it, they live on it, they deal with it, and then they try the best they can adapt in it. Temperature in Africa have been rising faster than global mean surface temperature. In terms of rainfalls, they are below long-term means in certain part of Africa. Reduction in precipitation is likely in Northern Africa and western part of Southern Africa, because in Southern Africa and western of the Atlas Mountains in Northern Africa, they are below the average, and the other region is above the average. And then the sea level is also increasing. It reached 5 millimeters per year in several oceanic areas surrounding the continent, and exceed in certain area 5 millimeters per year. Heat wave and warm spell duration will increase, and suggesting an increased persistence of hot days toward the end of the century. And this is very well documented also. Africa is very well known as a vulnerability hotspot, and then for impact of climate variability and change. And from various analysis also, it's indicated that it appears that urgent efforts and then should be pursued to enhance resilience through appropriate prevention, risk management strategies throughout the continent. And then that means a multi-hazard early warning system is needed, enhance synergy among various levels at various levels, from the local, national, regional, at global level is important. And then we need also to increase better understanding of those multi-hazard effects, and in order to be able to define a clearly informed strategy. Many institutions, such as the World Meteorological Organization, with different programs, are working in increasing the observational system to go beyond the early warning system adapted to climate variability, and then to link it to the climate change. The future of the continent is open to absorb any new idea, any innovation, because there is no lock-in effect. And then the agricultural system can be completely redesigned, redefined to move toward a more sustainable system. And then by bringing together, you know, some of the critical elements such as water availability, and then to moving from the rain-fed agriculture to the irrigation system. The energy sector is the same thing. And also there is a great political consciousness, political will, and then to deal with those different issues. More and more research institutions, including the Academy, African Academy of Science, is now investing in knowledge generation to have a better understanding in order to inform policy decisions, so that having the political leaders interested more and more in climate issues, having the knowledge sector and then the academia working on the science, better understanding the regional science of climate, and then that give hope that most of the policies that will be from the local to the national to the regional level better informed on with science, and then that will help to enhance the resilience of the continent.